Hi, my name is Lisa Ray, and I'm a developer advocate with the Google Developer Relations team. If you're interested in fitness and you want to give yourself or your users more information with just the device you already have in your pocket, you're in the right place. Today I'm going to talk about the step sensors available, starting with Android KitKat. These step sensors are hardware sensors based on the accelerometer. They're designed to be low power and won't burn through your battery. The step sensors count steps during walking, running, and climbing stairs, and they're smart enough not to count activities like biking, driving cars, or riding in trains. Android has two sensors for step counting. The first is the step detector. It fires an event when a step is detected, one event per step. The only value it can return is one, so if you want to count steps, you have to do that yourself. There are two ways to receive events from the step detector, continuously or in batches. If you register your listener with a maximum delay of zero, then you'll get continuous events posted as fast as the sensor can produce them. The step detector has a pretty low latency, so the times at which you receive step events should correspond closely with the user's actual steps. On the other hand, if you don't need real-time reporting, you can allow events to be batched by providing a higher maximum delay. You'll still get one event per step, but in this example, the events could come at as much as 5 seconds afterward. This allows for optimization at the sensor level. So be a good Android citizen and only ask for events as quickly as you actually need them. The step counter is similar to the step detector in that it also sends one event per step. However, the value it sends is a cumulative number of steps. The step counter also takes a little longer to process the event, but it produces fewer false positives. So when accuracy is paramount, use the step counter. You can also request these events as continuous or batched. So how do we use these sensors? First, check the device runs at least Android 4.4 and that it has the sensors we want. You can require the sensors and minimum API level in the manifest. Or if your app can work without the step sensors, you can check programmatically for them using the package manager. The simplest way to use the step sensors is to listen for steps only while the app is running, unregistering and re-registering your listeners with the app lifecycle, and persisting the previous step count to add to the new values reported. It is also possible to use the step sensors in the background when the CPU is suspended. This requires manually flushing the sensor event queue before it overflows. Speaking of listeners, here's a sample sensor event listener. Once you've registered, you get a callback to unsensor change every time there's a step event, with some delay depending on whether you requested batched mode. This listener is for a step detector. Here we're implementing a step counter. At this point, we can go ahead and display the step count. Your listener will be different depending on the type of sensor and what you want to do with the data. To see this in action, please download the batch step sensor sample linked from the video description for a full working example of this code, and go take it for a walk. Thanks for watching.